Okay, so in this video I will be talking about endpoint detector. So the endpoint detector is basically how to decide my etching has been done. So basically you need an endpoint layer for this and some good detector. So I'll be telling you the best ones which are of industrial standards, so the currently very, very good, and the very cheapest one which is coming with your system, so you don't have to buy another one, because the industrial one can cost you lakhs of rupees. So the first one is optical emission spectroscopy, so which is the the standard industry standard. So basically what happens is this radicals, they give a peak at so basically you're measuring the intensity versus wavelength in these excited state or radicals. They give they have a particular, you know, characteristic wave, in a way you can say. For example, silicon fluoride, 14 nanometer fluoride radical and 704 nanometer, which I'm showing here by a couple. So what can happen? Let's say you have a dirty chamber. Okay, so you have done deposition to plasma and have a lot of silicon in the chamber, you know, because dirty chamber. What will happen if I measure the 704 nanometer peak? Okay, 704 nanometer peak, which is the fluorine radical with the time. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm cleaning my chamber with the SF6, let's say, and I'm measuring the fluorine radical concentration. As you expect, at the initial, the chamber is very, very dirty, so the most of the fluorine radical is being consumed, and at some point it will increase and then it will stabilize, and no more fluorine radical has been used. So here is your endpoint. That means your chamber has been cleaned with respect to the fluorine, with respect to the silicon concentration. On the other hand, you can also observe the peak of 440 nanometer, which is silicon fluoride. So initially you'll have a lot of silicon fluoride formation, but after some time it will decrease, and at some point you'll no longer have silicon fluoride radicals, and that will be your endpoint. So this is your rising and this is your lowering, so both can be used. So the optical emission spectroscope works in this way. There is only one condition because you must have good signal to noise ratio. So chamber have a lot of area, so it does not matter. But if you want to etch some devices, it becomes very, very hard. So the rule of thumb is your etching rate into etched area in centimeter square should be greater than 1. So that is the rule of thumb. Second industrial standard is laser endpoint interferometry. So what happens is you are measuring the reflective intensity with time. So let's say you are etching your silicon with some boss process, and you have a silicon oxide as an end layer. So so what happens is, as you are etching, because you are etching constantly, you'll see this kind of peaks and valleys. But when you reach silicon oxide, which is the gases which are being used are more, they do not react much with silicon oxide as compared to silicon. So you see a line like this, a straight line, this, which is your endpoint. So here I'm showing you by cut. So you can measure also this, you can measure the thickness just by looking at how much you are etching per minute, just by looking at if you know the refractive index of your material being etched, wavelength of laser is always known. So that is the way you can measure your endpoint. Also looking at the signal, you can measure that. Only drawback here is your laser should be focused on the point, which is normally 100 microns of diameter. So the area should be more than 100 microns at least. So 300 microns is the best number. It's a good number, not the best number. That is one of the way. Now I'm going to talk about the cheaper endpoint detector, because you'll have which is available with your system. So let's say you have something called APC, which is automatic position controller, which is how much your valve has to open to maintain that amount of pressure. Let's say 10 millitor of the your chamber pressure. So what happens is, when your RF is on, let's say you raise this pressure and you started your RF, your valve is opening at some point and it maintains it, right? But when your etch starts, okay, when your etch starts, that means you have a lot of things coming out, okay? A lot of gases coming out, so your valve has to be your valve has to correspondingly decrease the mouth of the valve. So in older system, it does not have this control. So what it used to have is your pressure will again, your etching starts, your pressure will again, it will increase a lot. This is increased pressure, this is decreased pressure. So at some point, and then it starts constant, as you reach the your end point, you'll have no more of this etching happening. That means we'll reach the same pressure as before. So basically what happens is your pressure will change with time because of the amount of etching products you'll have in your chamber. Another thing you can also see is the DC bias. So there will be some DC bias developing across electrodes. Normally what happens is it will keep on increase or stable, but as soon as your etching is complete or the film is clear, it will again start to decrease, or it will go to some other level which is constant. So this is also a design point detector. There's one more. You can use your capacitor positions as an endpoint detection. So these are the matching capacitors, which is called phase and magnitude in Oxford system, load and tune in Centec system. So the time C1 and C2 will change their positions. For example, in start matching, because they have to match constantly and the plasma condition is changing apparently every time. So they will change from A to B position. So A position, you can imagine where does your etching products are more and more developing, and at end point it develops some stable phase after some point of time when your etching is complete. And same the magnitude other capacitor does in the same way. So basically you can look for these DC bias, capacitor position, APC, or the wall position, or the pressure in the chamber. They will give you an endpoint detection, which is the cheapest one, but you have to observe very, very carefully. Thank you.